In 2021, the management of a transplant in eligible and newly diagnosed myeloma patient is clearly evolving. We have to start from a VMP, continuous therapy with Lendex or VRd, as the classical standard of care, and the new combinations are basically based on the incorporation of the monoclonal antibodies, anti-CD38, and the reality today is based on the monoclonal antibody daratumumab in combination with either VMP or lenalidomide and dexamethasone, and VRd plus the anti-CD38 monoclonal antibodies are being evaluated in clinical trials that are going on. VMP plus daratumumab is a new standard of care because of the significant benefit not only in progression-free survival, but also in overall survival. And in addition, the benefit has been sustained across the different subgroup of patients, especially based on the frailty. And this is important because we can face elderly patients, frail patients that can benefit from this combination. Dara-Lendex is another standard of care, and I have to say that the median progression-free survival for Dara-Lendex in the MAIA study has not been reached yet, but it is expected to be, from my point of view, the longest one we've seen today in a phase III clinical study conducted in transplant-ineligible newly diagnosed myeloma patient. And just to remark also the benefit across the different subgroup of patients, and especially patients with high-risk cytogenetic abnormalities, median PFS 45 months, and this would be the first choice for this population. And again, the addition of daratumumab to Lendex significantly improved the outcome, not only for the fit patients, but also for the frail population. So in summary, I think that the future is definitely based on the incorporation of the anti-CD38 monoclonal antibodies to the current standard of care. And in fact, this has been recognized by the recent European guidelines published just some weeks ago.